Hello, good afternoon, everyone.
Hello, good afternoon.
Okay, so the people who know me already know how this is gonna go. Because that, let's try that.
Come on.
Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Oh, okay, so it sounds a little bit like maybe you all woke up and had coffee at least. So we're gonna try that one more time. Hello, good afternoon, everyone.
Hey.
My name is Nikisha Elena Alexis, and I'm so excited to welcome you today to the Soul of Hip Hop in the Church in America, hosted by Anabaptist Mennonite Biblical Seminary, where I am a staff member and also an alum. First of all, can we please give DJ Nikki Nice a round of applause? For keeping us lively on this cold Elkhart day. Let's also give a giant hand to everybody who donated a book to the Tulsa Center today. We will be collecting books throughout today's event and at our Intercultural Competencies workshop on the AMDS campus tomorrow, which starts at 8:30 a.m. Hip-hop music and culture have a complex place in American society. Its history begins within marginalized communities of the Bronx, New York City, among African Americans and Puerto Ricans, and immigrants of Caribbean and Latin American descent, who drew its rhythms and its vocalizations from the traditions of the African diaspora, and remixed them for another sound at another time. And in its short, nearly 50-year existence, its cultural expressions, rapping, breakdancing, DJing and turntablism, graffiti, beatboxing, and its ever-changing street styles have influenced cultures far beyond that small borough, reshaping people of all identities across the planet. Despite its profound impact on our global landscape, hip-hop still occupies a tenuous space in the collective consciousness. It's both loved and loathed, appropriated and dismissed, it's both mainstream and suspect. On the one hand, hip-hop has proven itself to be a lucrative product that constantly transforms fashion, music, dance, and everyday language. It is created, extracted, packaged, and sold. It can be found everywhere from nighttime dramas, my empire on television, I think, to commercials for Oreos. And if you haven't seen the Biggie Smalls Oreos commercial, it's a little weird. Yet its primary source material continues to be individuals and communities who are pressed to the political, economic, social, and racial fringes, who are largely excluded from the profits the industry generates off their reality, their struggles, and their stories. When it comes to the church, there are Christians, myself included, who like hip-hop. And there are even those who would go so far as to trust its form to communicate the gospel. Yet its place is still largely outside the church, as a thing to be embarrassed about, or as competition to overcome. It remains conspicuously absent from most worship services and ministry initiatives, except on those rare and sometimes dubious occasions when we're trying real hard to track down those hard-to-attract youth. Even the terrain among those who are passionate about hip-hop can be choppy. There are strong critical debates within the movement about the way the industry limits and depicts women, about the dominant correct characterizations of blackness and masculinity, about the value of its narratives around street economics and addiction and violence, about who's real and who's fake and who does or doesn't get to decide. Hip-hop is complicated, controversial business. And it is into this dynamic swirl of things that I invite us to enter together. Today, let us explore hip-hop in the company of Dr. Daniel Whitehodge, who has joined us all the way from Chicago. Can we give him a hand? Educated commentator, a thinker, a theologian, and a leader who honors the genius of the genre and sees within it wisdom, even to the practice of faith in the way of Jesus in these days. Let us celebrate in the spirit of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who called that an uprising to be powered in part by singing and storytelling and song. Let us be inspired in this new moment of old hostility toward black life, black voices, and black mattering, toward immigrants and neighbors from afar, toward the kinds of people who brought hip-hop to life in the first place. So shall we begin?
Yes.